After the destruction of the foundry, completely accidental, but admittedly due to your fire magic, you and your family flee to the countryside to hide from Baral. The wild creatures out here scare you at first, but you soon realize that a beast attack is just another chance to practice your pyromancy. Chandra versus the Kaladesh Wildlife. So I'm expecting here to be fighting against a green deck. I like to see three lands. What's this? A new card. Chandra's Outrage. Deals 4 damage to target creature and 2 damage to that creature's controller. That's cool. I think we're going to keep this hand. I got the 3 mana, which is good. I'm going first. I don't have any early drops, but as we proved, this is more of a control deck. So I need to kind of bide my time here. Now he's playing green, so he's either playing a fast green deck where he's going to play a bunch of guys out and try to kill me really fast, or build up into really big creatures. Let's see. We'll play a land. The only thing I have for 2 is this Pyromancer, which I want to play as soon as possible. Because every time I play an instant or sorcery spell, I get a red elemental. So playing this before any of the instants or sorceries I have is the optimal play. Alright, and does he play anything? No. So he's probably stuck with a bunch of high cost stuff. So I'm inferring that he's probably playing more for a deck that has big guys. Let's see. We'll play this. So this is actually good right here. This Fire Fiend Elemental has renown. So we're gonna play. Oh, I don't have enough to play it. Shit, I thought it was 3. I don't want to play this Maniac Vandal yet because I want to wait till he has an artifact. He probably does not have any artifacts in his deck though. So we're just gonna go for an attack with our little young Pyromancer. And I'm holding back these cards for whatever he plays. So a common mistake that people do with fire decks is use the fire to burn your opponent, and that's the most inefficient use of them. They're better off against creatures. Unless if they're low enough that it'll kill them. When Giant Badger blocks, it gets +2/+2 into that turn. Oh shit. To 2/2, if it blocks, it becomes a 4/4. Do I want to kill that? Oh, I lost my chance. Yeah, I should have killed it on his turn, and then I would have had some elementals that could have attacked with. So that was a full bar. I can play it now, but I lost my chance at. So maybe we'll probably do it next turn. Is this an instant? Let's hang back. We're gonna hang back and see what he does. He's probably gonna attack me with this. I'm gonna skip the attack. If he attacks, I shoot it, still get my little elementals. But I want to see if he plays something big. He's gonna attack. He does not attack. Oh, it's hex-proofed. Hold on. We're gonna fire impulse to blow up that little badger. That'll give me these 2 guys. I can't use that. All right. What am I saying? 2. It gives me one guy here. Thinking I have 2 Pyromancers in play. We'll put a mountain. I can play this Fire Elemental. Yeah. We're going to play the Fire Elemental. And I'm going to attack with it. I'm going to attack with it. If he does not block, if he blocks it, kills that problematic creature. Yeah, we'll attack with that. He does block it. I did want to get rid of that. And I wanted to do it at a time that he was tapped out, so he can't do something to bump, puff, you know, make it bigger. Alright. I hate this. Those are going to be very problematic, and I'm sure he's got a bunch. Case in point. I can't shoot them. So I have to beat them on the ground. So. That doesn't help. This doesn't help. He probably does not have artifacts. Yeah, I gotta play this Maniac Vandal. We're not gonna attack. Skip the attack. Alright. I gotta wait for him to attack. He's not going to. He knows better. He's got a giant badger. Okay, I guess same thing like the other battle. I'm going to have to kind of hang back and win by the air. Another fiery impulse. I think I want to hold on to play this mountain. Again, I'm going to hold these off to the most optimal time to play them, which isn't now. So, we'll hang back. Patience is the key here, which is very unlike Red. So we have to win against his ground assault. Death touch. Oh, that's terrible. Is he doing this during my turn? He is. Shit. A 2-1 death touch. Hunt the weak. Put a +1/+1 on target creature you control. Then that creature fights target creature you don't control. Cock. Okay. Hold on. Shit. What did he do? Wait. Who did he kill? Do I fiery impulse that? I think I want to fiery impulse that badger. Yeah, fiery impulse that badger. See, at the beginning of your game, you can find more land. Oh shit! Holy crap! Well, I really wish I would have saved that impulse now. I have time though. I need to draw. That's not exactly what I wanted. +1/+1 counters. If I don't kill this now, it's going to become a 5/5 that I will not be able to kill. So I'm going to have to spend 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I could do both. I'll have to Chandra's Outrage it now because I won't be able to later. He's got 5 lands, so that's going to become a 5/5. Right? +4, +1. Oof, shit. No way, that needs to go away. And then I can play my Phoenix here. And then I will attack with the Phoenix. I gotta win by air, looks like. Of course, green has ways to shoot down air guys. Okay, yep. My blockers are keeping them home. He plays a Lost in the Woods. Whenever a creature attacks you or a planeswalker in control, reveal the top card of your library. If it's a forest card, remove that creature from combat. Then put the revealed card on the bottom of your library. Okay. Interesting. Remove it from combat. That just means it won't get to do damage. So, this is nice. Okay, let's go into attack phase. Let's see what happens with this my Phoenix here. So it's a chance that the Phoenix that's flying may get lost in the woods. It does. Okay, so it does no damage. And I'll put out this Fire Elemental to protect against stuff. So now I got these little guys that can protect against this Viper, and my Fire Elemental can stop this that Hunt Beast. Alright, a Crawl Worm. Oh my god, I haven't seen one of these in a long time. A 6'4 guy with nothing special. Other than being really big. A mountain was not what I wanted to see come through. We will attack with our Phoenix there. What am I gonna do when that worm attacks? Oh my god, are you fucking kidding me? What am I gonna do when that worm attacks? Probably block with my Fire Elemental. 2, 3, 4. I can chump block it with these guys. Whenever he casts a green spell, a forest, he gains life. Well, this guy would have been good against that. Now I know. He does not attack. He's worried here. Do I attack with this Pyro Charger? Hell yes. I think yes is the answer. So put that. Does this affect every creature? Yeah. Now the thing is this is going to help him. Shit. This is going to help him cycle through his deck and get to his better cards. And being red, I have nothing to say against enchantments. I can't get rid of that. Actually, I can hold this back to be a single blocker against that. So we will continue with just attacking with the Phoenix. Alright, so he did not get a force, so this will hit him. Okay, and then I'm gonna hang back with everything. Keep a wall against these big creatures. Alright, is he gonna attack? Probably not. He knows that if he attacks. Yeah. And you know, this is kind of giving me a hint in that I don't want to be attacking into that. Alright, we got Flames of the Firebrand. I don't have a Phoenix over here, so we're gonna hold this off. Do we need this for anything right now? No. Nope. So we will just go into our attack phase. You know, I kind of would like to attack with both of these. But this is only going to get blocked by one thing and then die. So we'll just attack with Phoenix. And once again, try to win by air slowly. Oh, I'd like to see that go to the bottom of his deck. And then we'll hold off. I'm gonna hold our burn here, especially because this one I can hurt him with it, which will let me get back my Phoenix if we lose it. I'd like to draw another Phoenix, except I drew a mountain. All right, let's go into attack phase. You know, this is very infuriating, winning by not even 2 points at a time. Son of a bitch. Okay. I would have never thought that I'd be playing a red deck the way I would play a blue deck. Very slow and plotting. But it looks like this is the way to win with this deck. You cannot just rush in an attack, especially when you join fucking mountains every turn. Jesus. Alright. I mean, he's gonna attack me on a big rush at some point. And he keeps drawing the fucking forests. Holy crap, it's pissing me off. 1, 2. Oh, how many forests does he have? 10. If I can get my other Phoenix, then I won't feel so bad. But I get... Oh. Yeah, this... this Fire Elemental is going to do is protect me from the big onslaught he's got building up. You know, I could go in for a big rush out attack, but I will be on the losing end because he's got all these defensive guys. He's got this Badger, it gets bigger. This Python, this Viper here, kills anything it touches. So, you know, it's just, that doesn't help. And I still didn't hit him. And every time he puts a force, he's gaining life. Yeah, at least the staff I have. Oh my god. Still lands. I need my other Phoenix. Of course. Jeez, this is ridiculous. And every time he casts a green spell, right, he gains a. Yeah. He's gonna keep gaining life with that. He's gaining more life with this than I am doing damage with this. And I have absolutely no answer to this. Red has no answer to that. Briar Pack Alpha, Flash. I guess +2/+2 to something. What did he put it on? That guy baited a 4/4. Is he going to go into a big attack? I don't need to block that. I don't need to block that. I'll take 4, putting me at 16. Are you kidding me with these freaking mountains? Oh my god. That's gotta be half my. Alright, so my chances of drawing better stuff should be higher now. With all this lands out. Alright, this does nothing else, right? So, let's see if we can get the damage in. Nope. Still Forest. He probably has 40 Forest in a 27 card deck still left. Alright. Whoever designed this Magic Duels, Chandra's deck here, I hate you. I hate you very much. Because it's taking forever just to play through freaking one match. And of course I'm still drawing nothing but fucking mountains. Alright. Chandra's Phoenix. He's gonna reveal a forest. Of course. And we still marinating here. I'm not sure why I'm holding the Firebrand, but I feel like I need to hold it. Alright. Here we go. Now we're blocking. He probably has something to bump this up, so I don't want to lose my Fire Elemental. I don't think. We will use this guy here. And then I just need to add 3. You know what? You know what I'm going to do? I'm going to confirm block. Hold on. I almost screwed that up. And we're going to bump this up all the way. Because you know what? It's his turn. I don't need to save the mana for anything else. So I'm doing that because if he plays something to buff this up, then it still dies. But he won't play it now because now there's nothing he has that can buff this up to the point where it'll survive how big this is going to get. I'm pretty sure he has a card in there that when he plays it will get a bonus to probably has another of these because that's a flash. Alright. So the reason we have to wait because each activation is a separate event and we have to wait till each one resolves completely. I'm willing to bet any money that he's got a creature buff in there. So you have a Chandra's Outrage here. Again, I want to see it. That's an instant. I want to save that. So let's go into our attack phase. And once again, have our Phoenix get lost in the forest. All right, show me the forest here. There we go. Why wouldn't it be a forest? And for a second there, our graphics got better. Oh, wizards, please fix magic duels. All right, we're hanging out here. All right, he's trying to bait me into blocking with my fire elemental. So we're going to... Should I just blast it? I'm gonna double block it. I'm gonna do this and this. Now, if it dies, I'm okay with that. If they all die, I'm okay with that. If he buffs it up, I blast it. He doesn't, so that's okay. Plays a crawl worm. I can blast that to Kingdom Come. With my outrage here. But again, I want to hold on to that as long as possible. This is interesting. Wish I had a fiery impulse. Man, I would love to attack with all of this. Wish I had a fire impulse to get rid of this guy. This guy is hindering my attacks with these guys. Well, I'll put out my fire elemental now. Let's go into attack phase. Alright, it can't be a freaking forest every single time. Can it? Can it? Can it be? It's not. Oh, what is he doing? Untap target creature gets +2/+2 and gains reach until end of turn. Ah! Wait a minute. He's gonna do it on what? He's doing it on the crawl worm. I shoot the crawl worm, it'll die before this happens. Because the way the spells get resolved, last in, first out. So, Chandra's outrage on the crawl worm. He'll take 4 damage, then die. And I get a little elemental. And now this does not help. And that's why I hold on to that spell until the last possible moment. Oh, and I finally got the hit. Oh, right, because he got through this shit. All right, again, we will hold on to this. And actually, all right, we're going to end our turn. If... Well, let's see what he plays. I might Flames of the Firebrand this and then attack with my fire elementals. I think it's time to stop. Oh, he attacks with that. Hell yeah, we are killing that. He has got nothing to buff it up, right? Right? Right, he's got nothing to buff it up. There's no way, right? I can block with 2 guys to kill it. That was a bad move. Why would he do that? Why would he do that? Expecting me to block with these? Alright, now I finally have advantage. Oh, and I have this. Oh, yeah. I'm definitely playing this. And attacking with it. I'm attacking with everything. Alright, that was... Now I think we finally break through. We attack with all except my little pyromancer that we need him alive. Yeah. Alright, so now he's got to do this effect for every single one. Alright, some guys are going to get through. Ah, no more forests, eh? They're on the bottom of your deck? He's got a bunch of stuff there, though. He's gonna... Oh. Well. Okay. That's fine. He double blocked, but he lost both his guys. And he's hoping to draw an Ambush Viper. No, he's dead. All right, so, God. All right, this is why I play very patiently, because... Actually, shit. I Flames of the Firebrand. I need... I need to keep this. So I will use the Flames of the Firebrand. Clear the way and hopefully win. I possibly might win now. So let's Flames of the Firebrand. We're going to do one damage to that and the other two to him. Gives me a little Fire Elemental there. And we attack with all. Including my little Pyromancer. Because he's got nothing to play. He can't. There's nothing he can do to kill him right now. So, somebody... Alright. Somebody's going to get through. A few guys are going to get through. Is it enough? I don't know who it's affecting. Alright, he should be dead here. And that is it. Maybe it's not so bad being on the lam. You've been tangling with beasts and honing your pyromancy, and your family has found a comfortable village to stay in. As long as Brawl's forces don't catch your trail, maybe even a wanted pyromancer can enjoy a bit of freedom.